slayed yet another boss, and we obtained a new item, a lab coat that lets us teleport to walls. I think I want to be going this way. We have the ability to teleport through one tile-wide blocks. That opens up quite a bit of exploration for us. First, though, we should always save when going into a new area. Though, actually, it's not always advantageous to save. Whenever you die, you get teleported back to the last point you saved at. This can actually be really helpful in certain locations. Like, at certain points in the game, you have to go pretty much across the entire map to get to your next destination, to pick up an item or a key or something, only to have to trek all the way back. So you can basically do a death teleport by saving near the objective that you need the new item for. Going all the way across the screen, or all the way across the map, getting the item you need, and then killing yourself so that you go back. Teleport through that one just yet. Let's go up. See what's happening. Oh. Open area. Damage don't inspire much confidence in me right now. These guys I can't kill. And this is Indy. Actually, we do have to go through there. Huh. Alright. Because I can't jump high enough to get to the big, round thing. Alright. Back up we go. Okay, the drill can pierce them. So, that's when I really want to. Come on. Teleport is so finicky. Can't go that way. Yeah. Can't decorrupt those blocks. Can't go that way because I'm not small enough. Ow. One thing to keep in mind, or at least with my gamepad it is, the buttons are pressure sensitive, and if you don't depress them all the way, for, as you can see, the drill is not fully extended. Unless I have the button all the way pushed down. Is an achievement for beating the game with only one death, as opposed to the many, many deaths that I have suffered so far. Yeah, I'm not going to be getting that achievement this playing. called Drone. That thing's adorable. And it can break blocks. Well, it looks like we found out our way to get to one tile wide half passes. Second time to activate it prematurely. Meaning it can go into different rooms without you. It does not have the ability to corrupt enemies, however. The drone. Oh, there was that one wall over here that we couldn't pass through. Now let's just hope we can survive long enough to get there. Get lasered in the face. Alright, so this thing does not really do that much damage. I has a nifty effect, but it's really low power. Well, the advantage, though, is that it is fast firing, and also dying there just restores our health. So, bright side. We'll be right back. blocks. You can break these blocks now. You can break these blocks. That's useful. That is definitely worth the save. Was a lot of damage. I don't think we're supposed to be coming here just yet.
Thank you.
good health fragment. And that is boss noise. Oh, it's another Bigums. Oh, hey, negotiation might work. So this guy's weak spot is his little... is the green spot on his back. And the reason why we have this weapon equipped is because it's really convenient to hit him with it. Decides that he wants to cooperate and be within the correct range. This fight is taking so long, the music looped. That That's... it's actually kind of sad. Unduck or something? Oh, well, whatever. I'm right in front of the boss room anyway. I would like a little more attack power going into this fight, but... oh, actually, I could probably use the Nova. That should... rapid fire option, but I have a much better chance of detonating it where it'll actually hit him. Thankfully, it doesn't make me go through the cutscene again. Wow, I just realized how slow this thing fires. Significantly better damage. So this fight shouldn't be nearly as long as that last one was. Alright, yeah, just crouch right on top of the shot. That's fine. You've already detonated. Go again. Take 3 now. shots. Let's try and get me to jump into it too early. Okay, yeah, shot to the face makes it back. I don't like that pause that you had in there, Elsnova. Alright, what's our present for killing the big scorpion idiot? Oh, it's another one of the Rasalki. Or a dead Rasalki. I'm in your head. Well, now we know how they kill her. Thank you. Professor Brain worked out good. Maybe. They fight. They fight enemies. That's nifty. Alright, so let's go back up to this area and see what sort of new treasure we can get. Still haven't gotten the health up for killing the boss. With Super Metroid. Ooh. What do we have here? Grapple Beam! So, Grapple is different from Super Metroid in Axiom Verge, in that it's extremely finicky, first off. And second, it will only latch onto horizontal surfaces. So, you can't, like, fire it at a vertical surface and expect to be able to use it. Also, sometimes it will randomly unlatch regardless of what you're trying to do. Normally it's supposed to stay latched as long as you hold the button, but occasionally it decides, nah, we don't want to stay latched. have the ability to grapple, I should be able to get it. Provided grapple decides to be cooperative. Oh, so that's how you get it. Okay, so I don't need to grapple across the top. Cool. Over here. Nope. Oh, there's something up there, but let's see if I can get up. Wrong mini health node. So, well, that starts me towards my next one. On my first playthrough of the game, that was the last one that I found because I kept skipping over it, thinking I'd already gotten it. Yeah. I'm good at this game, really. No, not really. Alright. Well, with that being said, and with the very convenient save point right over here, that is going to be it for tonight. Thanks for tuning in, and join me next week when we continue our journey through the world of Axiom Verge. Have a good night, guys.